All right, thank you so much for joining me. My name is Liz, and today I will be leading you through a 45-minute power yoga class. I don't have any props, as you can see, no blankets, blocks, or straps, bolsters. If you're practicing at home, please feel free to bring in any of those props if you have them, yoga specific or not. Maybe using a couch pillow or a regular blanket, comforter, robe, anything that you'd like. So let's begin in a standing position. Feet are hip distance apart or wider. Standing mountain pose. Let's take a deep breath in through the nose. Release through the mouth. Let's do two more of those, maybe rolling the shoulders back. Letting go of what no longer serves you. Inhale. Exhale. On our next breath in, let's raise the arms overhead. Let's hook the thumbs, and on the exhale, reach the arms to the right, grounding through your right heel. Taking a breath or two here. If we can, begin shifting the breath in and out of our nose. Deep side stretch there. Inhale to center, reach tall. Exhale to the opposite side. Ground through your left heel to support the side body. Keep the knees soft, core engaged. Inhale, reaching to the sky, lengthen the spine. Exhale, lower prayer to heart center. Let's bring the hands to the knees. Take a deep bend into the knees. Taking a nice deep breath in, neutral spine here. As we exhale, tuck the chin towards the chest, curve the back, spread the shoulder blades apart. This is like a standing cat pose. Inhale, chest reaches forward, shoulders reach back. Exhale, rounding the spine. Doing this a few times at your own pace. Again, shifting the breath in and out of the nose if we can. And creating some circles if you'd like to add some movement. Kind of side to side. Get creative. You're in your own space right now. So hopefully making any movements that feel good and you have that ultimate freedom, no limitations of movement right now. Inhale back to our center, knees are still bent. Let's heel toe the feet wider, sort of very wide stance now. Hands can still rest on the thighs or around the knees. Let's lengthen the spine, avoiding any shrugging of the shoulders. Take a deep breath in. As you exhale, draw the right elbow towards the center. Open the chest to the left. Inhale slowly to center, unwind. Exhale, opposite shoulder draws towards the center. Inhale, center. Exhale, right shoulder. And we're really broadening through the chest and collarbones here. One more time. Here we go. And the last time on the left. Inhaling to center, let's heel toe the feet together, hip distance, mountain pose, Tadasana. Shine the palms forward, inhale, the shoulders rise towards the ears. Exhale, roll them down and back. Feel free to do a few of those, or we can stay here in stillness in our mountain pose. And just for a moment, we're going to practice a pranayama called Ujjayi breath, or ocean's breath. Just to describe the breath so we can really experience the full extent, this will help us with our practice when we get deeper into postures. Let's bring our hand in front of our face and imagine that it is a mirror. And this is a dirty mirror that we'd like to clean. So inhale through the nose and exhale, fogging up this dirty mirror. Keep the chin slightly dropped, Raise the crown of the head taller. One more time. Keep the hand here. Let's close the mouth. Exhale through the nose. Keeping that same slight restriction in the back of the throat, see if you can create that whispering sound. One more time. Lower the hand. This is our Ujjayi breath. When we get into more difficult postures later, I might ping in, hey, let's tap into that Ujjayi breath. Inhale the arms overhead, reach high, coming to the top of our mat. Exhale to gently forward fold, lengthen the spine. Weight is in our toes. Inhale to half lift, knees are soft. Exhale to fold. Heel toe the feet, hip distance or wider, grab opposite elbows or forearms. Ragdoll pose, just for a moment. Allow the head, the neck to hang heavy, soft. The lower body stays grounded, stays still. This is our foundation. The upper body, we can have a slight sway. Draw the navel in. Reach the belly towards the thighs. It's okay if they're not touching. Let's inhale the arms halfway lift. Fingertips come to the mat or the shins. Lengthen the spine. Exhale to fold. Inhale, arms to the sky, coming up with a straight spine or a curve, depending on your preference. Exhale, lower prayer to heart center, Anjali Mudra. Inhale, arms to the sky. Exhale, bend at the knees, chair pose, Utkatasana. Relax the shoulders. Arms and fingers are engaged, reaching forward. Heel toe the feet together to meet. Maybe the knees, the toes, ankles touch. Deep inhale. Exhale, bring your prayer to heart center. Draw the heart further in front. Hips will go back. One breath, and as we exhale, we're going to bring the left elbow to the outside of the right knee. Revolve chair pose. Notice if our shoulders are coming down. Let's open. Open this top shoulder up. Heart is reaching to the right side. Now very slowly, we're going to step back with the left leg. We can always bring the fingertips to the mat and then step back for more stability. Revolved crescent lunge. See if you can find the weight, balance between both of the feet. Breathing here. On our next inhale, let's unwind the arms, reaching the arms up and forward. Now we're not coming all the way up, but we've created a nice diagonal line with the body. Take a breath in. As we exhale, sweep the arms back. Heart reaches forward, open through the shoulders and chest. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, sweeping back. One more time. Deep breath. Use the Ujjayi breath, beautiful. Inhale the arms overhead. Exhale, prayer to heart center. Begin bringing the weight into the front leg. We can hop the back toes up or come straight into a warrior three posture. Flexing the back foot, press outward through the heel. Arms can stay at heart, hands to the hips, reaching out in front of us or behind us. See if you can keep that left hip lowered and in line. On our next inhale, draw the knee up towards the chest as you stand and release. Beautiful. Inhaling arms to the sky. Exhale, prayer to heart center. Let's do two more of those. Very nice. Keeping the knees soft, jaws relaxed. Inhale, arms to the sky. Exhale, chair pose, Utkatasana. Bend the knees. Heel toe the feet together to touch. Deep inhale. Exhale, prayer to heart center. Let's sink the heart and the hips lower. Deep breath in. Exhale, twisting to the left. Right elbow comes to outside of left knee. Now our right hip may want to draw forward, but let's reach it back in line with the right or the left. Taking a nice breath in, let's step back, right leg. RhythOM crescent lunge. Keep the belly button drawn in towards the spine. Continue to broaden through the chest. See if you can bring the weight out of the elbow. Really keeping the weight in the legs. On an inhale, unwind, reach the arms up and forward. Here's our diagonal line again. Exhale, arms sweep back. Inhale, arms sweep forward. Use that ujjayi breath. Exhale, sweeping back. Inhale, sweeping forward. Exhale, back. Inhale, arms come up. Bring the prayer to heart center, slowly finding our way into warrior three. Lifting the back foot. Using a wall, any props that we need here to feel stable. One more breath in, stay as you exhale. Inhale, draw the knee towards the chest, come to standing and release. Taking three breaths in through the nose, out through the mouth. Body stays soft, tuning back into our breath if we've lost it. Inhale, the arms reach overhead. Exhale to forward fold. Spine is straight, knees are soft. Inhale to half lift. Exhale, forward fold. Stepping both feet back, coming to a high plank position. Feel free to lower the knees at any time. Focusing on pressing, spread the fingers wide, pressing the fingertips, the pads of the knuckles. Round the upper back, make sure our shoulders are dropping down. Deep inhale, one more breath. Exhale, lift hips, downward facing dog. Reaching the heart back. Taking one more breath in, exhale, lower the knees to the mat, shift the bones to the heels, rest the head for child's pose. Taking a few moments here, noticing what comes to your mind in these in-between moments. Oftentimes we're so used to boom, 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 things happening really fast in our lives, but when there's a halt, when there's a pause, where does our mind gravitate? Let's look forward at the hands. Arms are stretched out in front of us. Arms are parallel to each other and the mat. Draw the weight forward to hands and knees, tabletop position. Let's lower the forearms to the mat. Forearms are parallel as well. Spread the fingers wide. We're coming into a dolphin pose, so tuck the toes, inhale here. Exhale, lift the hips. This is also a modified downward facing dog. Engage the shoulders, press down through the forearms, the elbows, really focus on those fingertips, lift the hips high. On an inhale, walk the feet away from you, lowering the hips to a dolphin plank. Draw the navel in towards the spine, keep the upper back rounded. On your exhale, lift the hips, walk the feet forward towards the elbows as high as you can get them. Ujjayi breath, inhale, walk the feet back slowly. Exhale, walk the feet forward. Inhale, walk the feet back. Exhale, last time. Here's your dolphin pose and hold. Lower the knees gently. Sit back onto the heels. strap can be, or a t-shirt, a blanket, feel free to use this. Let's inhale the arms out to the sides. And then we're going to bring the right arm overhead. The other hand will come behind you. I'll turn around for an example. So right arm is above, reaching to the base of the skull, the top of the back. The other hand, the back of the hand will come to the back. And if we can, having our strap here, a blanket, a t-shirt, or if you are able to clasp your fingers together, this is cow face arms. So we're practicing on opening the shoulders. Again, if this is inaccessible to you, using a strap or a t-shirt. We can also just hold the elbow at the top. On our next inhale, arms come out to the sides. Exhale, the opposite arms. Cow face arms. Keep the heart reaching forward. Draw the navel in. Send the hips forward as well. We can feel a slight engagement through the core. Inhale, the arms reach out to the sides. Exhale, eagle arms. So bringing the right arm over. Feel free to cross the forearms, or if we're not feeling that today, you can hug opposite shoulders. Whichever arm position we're in, lift the elbows to eye level or just about to the chin. Continue the engagement through the core. Maybe add a smile. Inhale, the arms reach out to the sides. Exhale, opposite eagle arms. So again, whichever way we decide. Lifting the elbows, navel draws in, core is engaged. Fix your gaze, maybe find a drishti point, your point of focus. Inhale the arms up and around. Exhale, we're gonna walk our hands back to a child's pose. Coming out here. Inhale to table position. Lower your forearms to the mat, coming back into dolphin pose. Forearms are parallel, spread your fingers. If you have a block, feel free to have a block holding, your hands can hold the block between here. Let's lift the knees. Hips come up towards the sky, dolphin pose. Seeing how far we can walk the feet up towards the elbows. As we're here, lift the right leg to the sky. And we're going to do 10 pulses. So actively engaging this right leg. Pulse on your exhale. Keep the hips square. Feel free to jump into a forearm stand if you are familiar and comfortable. Lowering that foot, going right to the other side. Engage the left leg. Press through the forearms. Keep the chest engaged as well. Draw the navel in. Lower the feet. Lower the knees. Shift the sit bones back to the heels, rest the head for child's pose. Again, if you want to incorporate any forearm stand play here, feel free to kick the legs up, practice any tucks. Knees can be together or apart. Allow the head and the neck to rest here. On an inhale, walk the arms and the hands to the right side of the mat. Left hand will come on top of the right. Breathe into the side body. Inhale, the hands walk to the center. Exhale, crawl the fingertips over. Right hand rests on the left. Allow yourself to relax. Giving yourself permission here to take a break. And knowing that that is perfectly okay. Thank you.
elbows back towards the feet, the legs, and release the hips to the mat. Feet are out in front of us. Very nice. So legs are stretched out in front, hands are down by the hips. A lot of engagement here. This is our staff pose. The body is in a 90-degree angle. If you have a block at home, or two, placing the blocks, beside each leg. I like to start with it on the shorter end. So we're going to do some core engagement, working the hips, strengthening through the center of the body. So hands stay here. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, lift the left leg over the block. Foot is flexed. Coming back over. Inhale. Exhale, opposite foot over the block. Inhale at center. Doing this four more times. Three more on each side. Use your breath. Keep the chest lifted. Continue. You can do it. Maybe starting with something small is our last one. Very nice. Now, if you'd like, if you have blocks or you have, you know, a dog toy, a ball around the house, you can bring that there. If it's taller, you can flip your blocks to make them more difficult, more of a challenge. If not, if we have nothing here, that's perfectly fine. Take a deep breath in, doing five more on each side. Exhale, lift the left heel. Inhale, exhale, use your breath. There we go. So this is activating through the thighs, through the hips. And here we go. I think that was five on each side. So bending the knees, I like to create some room here. Inhale, draw the chest forward. Exhale, tuck the chin, curve the spine. Inhale, chest forward. Practicing spinal flexion. Exhale, curve back one more time. Very nice. Inhale, the chest rises, come into a neutral spine, slightly drop the chin, crown of the head reaches tall. Lift the heels off of the mat, maybe release the arms in front of us. Whenever you're ready, lift legs, boat pose. So I'm coming into sort of half boat pose. On an inhale, let's straighten the legs, lower the back. Exhale, lift to a high boat. Inhale, low boat. Exhale, high. Three more. Inhale low, exhale high. And hold. That is a toughie. One more breath. Reach the hands forward and lower the feet. Inhale, chest rises up. Exhale, tuck the chin, curl back. Inhale, chest forward. Exhale, curl back. Slowly walk the hands down the legs, rolling all the way back onto the mat. Bring the heels close to the bum, as close as we can, without turning the knees inward or outward. We want them hip distance apart. Arms come down by the sides, palms to the mat. Take a deep inhale. Exhale, lift the hips. Bridge pose. If you can, slowly walk the shoulders one at a time. Just walking the shoulders underneath the back. This will take some pressure off of the neck. If you have the flexibility in the shoulders, interlace the fingers underneath you. Press the arms and the hands into the mat. Engage the inner thigh. Press through the big toes and the inner part of each foot, driving the hips to the sky. Make sure the knees aren't falling in or out.
Heel toe the feet together, knees touch. Lifting the right leg, if you feel comfortable, flex the foot, press the heel. Lower the foot, lift the opposite leg. Keep engaging through that inner thigh. And lower. Holding bridge pose, feel free to heel toe the feet wider to hip distance. Ujjayi breath. Slowly crawl the shoulders out from underneath you, palms come to the mat. From the top of the spine all the way down, roll the back down to the mat. Bring the knees into the chest. Feel free to do any rocks or circles here. Massaging the hips. The muscles around the sacrum, the low back there. I like to create half circles, focusing on one side and then going to the other. That is my personal preference. But noticing the different areas in the back, the shoulders, the upper sides and lower areas. Noticing them and then practicing some self-love. Tuning in. Bring the right knee into the chest, release the left leg to the mat. Holding here or open the knee to the side. If we do open the leg to the side, make sure your hips and your shoulders are evenly resting on the mat. Feel free to extend that leg out as well. If you can, reach for the ankle, the big toe, or if you have a strap handy. Bring the knee into center if it's not there already. Switch the knees, bring left in, release right. Breathing here for a moment, then opening to the side if you wish. And keep the areas of the body soft. The knees, the thighs, the chest, the neck. Cool down. Bring the knee to center. Both knees come in. Doing our last few little rocks or movements. Feel free to add any twists into here before we enter Savasana. Feel free to also incorporate any other postures that you are familiar with. Maybe happy baby pose, staying still or rocking. Also, if you are familiar with plow pose, when the feet come behind you, practicing any poses that serve you in this moment today. Slowly releasing one foot at a time to the corners of the mat. Arms fall out beside you, palms facing up. Corpse pose, Savasana. Closing the eyes or softening the gaze. If you have a window near you or a light on in the room and you wish to have a darker setting as you relax, feel free to bring a cloth, a towel, or a t-shirt over the eyes for your relaxation. And coming into full body relaxation here, following my next cue, seeing if you can give yourself this chance just for you. reach the arms overhead, pointing the toes. And slowly roll onto the left side of the body for a moment. Taking your time, there's no rush in your movement. Using a pillow or a blanket here to get comfortable, maybe a blanket. And as you're here, I invite you to think of something that you are proud of yourself. At least one thing. It can be more than one thing. Maybe it's continuing your yoga practice at home. You're proud of yourself for doing that. Maybe you just graduated. Maybe you just paid off your car. Or maybe you're in your 10th day of your meditation practice for the first time. It can be anything. Sit with yourself here for a few breaths, giving yourself that acknowledgement and the recognition that you deserve. And what are you proud of you for? Slowly press up to a comfortable seated position on your mat. Again, there's no rush in the transition. Feel free to keep the eyes closed if they weren't already. Still keeping the forehead, the eyes, the jaw relaxed. Placing the palms face down on the knees, a gesture to ground us. Slightly drop the chin to raise the crown of the head taller. Not dropping the chin too much, just slightly. And let's switch the feet the opposite way that we normally would come into our easy pose, Sukhasana. Fix your gaze or close your eyes. Soften through the chest and the heart. And as we enter practice today, I'd like to share a meditation with you called Metta, Loving Kindness. So after each verse, just repeating to yourself, either out loud or in your mind, and hopefully embracing the words. May I be happy. May I be healthy. May I live with ease. May I be free from dis-ease. May I be happy. May I be healthy. May I live with ease. May I be free from dis-ease. Now changing the word I to you and sending this message out to maybe a loved one, a friend, or just our community here or on a global standard. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you live with ease. May you be free from. from dis-ease. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you live with ease. May you be free from dis-ease. Sending that love, that support out to whomever comes to mind. And changing the word you back to I one more time. Just as all things in the universe, whatever we put out, will come back to us. May I be happy. May I be healthy. May I live with ease. May I be free from dis-ease. Let's bring the hands out to each side. On an inhale, reach the arms up and overhead, sending out that gratitude, love, support. Reach high, exhale, lower palms to heart center, Anjali Mudra. Ending our practice with mantra Sat Nam. I recognize the divinity within you. Sat Nam. Thank you very much for joining me, everyone. Power Yoga, we have many classes here that offer power, slow vibes, and a nice vinyasa flow. Everything is going to be coming up later today. We have a few classes online, live stream. We also have a YouTube channel, House of RhythOM. To view future classes, please feel free to head to our website, houseofrhythom.com.